The wide range of temperature for which gallium can be in the liquid state made this metal very useful for high temperature thermometers. However, this is not the main use of this metal. Some gallium compounds such as phosphide, arsenide and antimonide have important applications in the semiconductor industry. Particularly, gallium arsenide has been used in optoelectronic devices as a light emitting diodes or LEDs, photodetector laser diodes and solar cells. Gallium arsenide exhibits increases capabilities as semiconductor over silicon, such as it has a greater electron mobility, it uses less power and generates less heat. This technology is being used and investigated widely for high-speed transistor electronic in supercomputers. The use of gallium arsenide as a key component of LEDs is based on its efficiency to convert electrical energy into light. The emitted light can be tuned by doping the semiconductor with other elements. For example, when gallium arsenide is alloyed with phosphorus, a red light is emitted. The use of LEDs in our daily life is most extended that as a substitute of incandescent lamps or signal lamps in all type of electronic equipment. A new generation of LEDs are being investigated involving gallium nitride and is alloyed with indium, that is indium gallium nitride. This new generation of LEDs are viewed as the most promising semiconductor for high power and high temperature electronic devices. The band gap in gallium nitride is ideal for blue laser diodes and LEDs. Additionally, binary or ternary alloys allow to tune the band gap over the entire visible spectrum. The increase in research about gallium nitride has been reflected in the market, where it has been frequent since 1999. Gallium nitride based devices such as Blu-ray, HD, DVD players, and so on. A less known use of gallium, but also relevant, is as neutrino detector. Also, in order to obtain detectable data, are necessary big amounts of the elements. In the case of indium, its large use is in thin field coatings. One of the more important companies in this area found in the market is the indium thin oxide, which is about 80-90% containing indium oxide. Indium oxide is a transparent conducting oxide, but interestingly, when indium oxide is doped with about a small fraction of thin oxide, the transparency is not substantially affected, but it increases both electrical conductivity and heat reflectivity. That makes indium thin oxide very useful as a conductive coating material for flat panel computer displays, in smartphone, television screens, architectural glass panels, rear windows of vehicles or aircraft windscreen. Indium thin oxide is a compound transparent to visible light, but not to infrared light, which together with its high conductivity made really useful, for example, as de-icing when it's electrically heated. Other uses of indium are in low melting alloy and solders. Alloy are used in safety links, fuse and sprinkle system. The use of indium as a base of material in low melting solders provides some advantage compared to the thin lead solders due to the highly resistant to thermal fatigue and lower crack propagation. However, these solders are very expensive and somewhat difficult to obtain. Finally, indium also is used as semiconductor, usually combined with gallium in compounds such as indium gallium phosphide or indium gallium nitride, which are used for the production of LEDs, as how we have already discussed before. The last element of the group, thallium, is highly toxic, and some of these compounds, such as thallium sulfate, has been used as whole insecticide to kill ants and rats. This odorless and tasteless poison has been prohibited in the United States since 1975. The toxicity of thallium was really useful at the end of World War I as medicine to fight against tuberculosis and syphilis, although now has been banned. However, some thallium compounds are still present in some applications in our daily life. For example, the high electrical conductivity of thallium sulfide, which changes with exposure to infrared light, make this compound useful in photocells. Thallium is also used to form an alloy with mercury, which is reported to freeze at minus 60 Celsius degrees, 20 degrees below the freezing point of mercury. This alloy is used in thermometers and low temperature switches. Thallium is also present in semiconductors, for example, for doping selenium semiconductor in order to improve the performance of or for high temperature superconductor, as for example occurs with thallium oxide and thallium cuprate. Finally, the radioisotope thallium-201 with a half-life of 73.5 hours is used in medicine for cardiovascular imaging in order to identify how well blood flows into the heart. This is what is known as thallium stress test. During the procedure, a small dose of the radioisotope is administered to the patient through an IV while that person is walking on a treadmill. The isotope will flow through the bloodstream to finally enter the heart muscle through the coronary arteries. Through the recording of a special gamma camera, it is possible to detect the radiation emitted by the isotope and detect any issue that the heart could have. If the supply of blood is not correct, that will be detected by a less amount of thallium detected. The isotope is then rapidly eliminated from the body in urine. As you can see, nuclear medicine is very present in our lives and helps us to keep us safe and sound. With this relevant application, we finish the study of metal and metalloids of group 13. In the coming week, we will start to the study of elements of group 14. Until then, please keep on working with the homework of the week.